In this problem, we're given the size of a propane tank and we're going to charge it with 3.5 kilograms of propane, and we're going to keep the temperature 25 degrees C. And what we want to do is use the Peng-Robinson equation state to model the propane at these conditions, and we want to calculate what's the pressure in the tank. So the spreadsheet that's been developed for the Peng-Robinson equation state is from the Elliott and Lear thermodynamics textbook, and I provided a link here to that spreadsheet. We're going to go to the spreadsheet, but first let's look at the conditions that we're going to use. The pressure, we need to determine the temperature, 25 degrees C, so 298 K, and then the volume, so we have 80 liters. And keep in mind, this is the specific volume, so we want volume per mole. So we have 80 liters and 3.5 kilograms. So we're going to do some units conversion to put the volume in the units that are appropriate for the spreadsheet. And the spreadsheet uses cubic centimeters per mole. So that means 1 kilogram. 10 to the third grams, 10 to the third cubic centimeters per liter, and then the molecular weight, 44 grams per mole. If I do this calculation, I get 1,006 cubic centimeters per mole. So I have temperature and volume, I'm going to determine pressure. And what the spreadsheet's going to use is the critical pressure, the critical temperature, and the centric factor. Those happen to all be available in the spreadsheet. So now let's go and look at this spreadsheet and see how we determine the pressure for this system. Okay, so here we have the Peng-Robinson equation of state spreadsheet. And I've done a couple things. I've made some of the fonts bigger and highlighted them for the parts that we're most interested in. And now what I've done is put in the critical temperature, pressure, and centric factor, and I just went to the critical properties here and copied and pasted them here. I put in the temperature of our system and I just guessed the pressure, because the spreadsheet is set up to enter the pressure and temperature and calculate a volume. Since we're given a volume, we have to work a little differently. The one other thing I need to do to be able to work on this is that I'm going to go into review and unprotect the spreadsheet that allows me to change cells that otherwise are restricted. So I guessed 0.1 megapascals. The volume of my system, 1006, well, you can see at this condition, the vapor volume is much larger than that. This is the lower fugacity of the two. Here's the fugacity of the vapor. Here's the fugacity of liquid. Since this is lowered, it means at these conditions, we would be in the vapor phase, much too large a volume. So let's increase the pressure. Well, still in the vapor phase, still much too large. Still in the vapor phase, too large. Let's double it again. Now notice the lower fugacity is for the liquid. This much too small a volume. And so the vapor, of course, too large a volume. What's this mean? Where we went to liquid phase, too small a volume. We were in the vapor phase, too large. This means at these conditions, we must be in vapor-liquid equilibrium. So that means we need to determine the saturation pressure, and then we should be able to see if indeed that's the condition where we have equilibrium for the system at 298 K. So what I'm going to do, here's the fugacity ratio. That's the ratio of the vapor to the liquid fugacity. At saturation, this number is 1, so I'm going to go into data, into solver, and I'm going to change this fugacity ratio. That's my objective function. I want the fugacity ratio to equal 1. I'm going to change the cells for pressure, namely B8. And so if I tell it to solve, comes up with a solution, comes the pressure 0.95 essentially megapascals. Well, now the fugacities are equal, so we're in vapor-liquid equilibrium. Here's the liquid volume per mole. Here's the vapor volume. 1,000 is between these two, and so this means that roughly it says that half the volume is liquid and half is vapor. So we can calculate the exact amount, but what we're interested in here is what is the pressure. So when we fill the tank at these conditions with this many kilograms, we're going to be at saturation pressure, which is 0.95 megapascals or 9.5 bar pressure.